When I start, here you see the topic of my paper and also the main co-author of my paper, who is Alexander Karopkin, Konstantin Shevmarev from Altai State University, and Evgeny Batyaev from Lavrentiev Institute of Hydrodynamics. And in this audience, it is not necessary to explain why we considered the ice flexural gravity wave, but about the channel. The main experiment provided in the channel in real life, and also actually recently I realized that all numerical experiment also provide in the channel, not in the open water, because it is an infinite volume of the data, it is impossible. So we have a model of the channel of the river, simplest model for the river, and also that is very useful for the real experiment in the lab, in the tank, also in numerical tank. And many classical results 5 years ago, I showed this slide that many people work under the ice of infinite extent, and many results was obtained. That is, I guess also that as people here know many of this, but for the this slide was prepared for the radar satellite measurement of ice cover, and that the Henry reminds the Tibet to convoy to winter road, and that is the radar satellite measurement. And you can see that the displacement of the ice in the millimeters, but horizontal distance, that is in the meter. It is possible to see that is visible from the satellite and the radar, but you can see that this should be very precise measurement to see that is very, very small deflection in the ice. And so we will speak about the flexural gravity wave. And here I just remind that the how important the dispersional relation and phase speed, and how it is different from the water wave and fractional gravity wave. You can see the dispersional relation, which is for the water wave, and for the for the long wave, so k tends to zero. That is, we have the same curve here, but for the dispersion relation for the flexural gravity wave, that is, we have another limit. For if k tends to infinity, in both cases, that is, the phase speed tends to infinity, not like for the water wave. And if in the case of the water wave, we have only one critical speed. Possible to see only one critical speed, but for the case of the flexural gravity wave, we definitely have one minimum, and that is, we have a second critical speed. And also, that is very important, short wave can be faster than the long wave for the case of the flexural gravity wave. And many things was designed according to the minimum of the phase speed, for example, the Victor Kozin, he introduced the resonance method of destruction. That is, when the velocity of the load close the minimum of phase speed, phase velocity of flexural gravity wave, the water stop to support the ice sheet and support the only by the elastic property of the ice. And he says that is a resonance method. But I guess that it is a method known, and you can see that the photo in the breaking ice in ice breaking by hovercraft in St. Lawrence River in Canada, and that is again they use the same properties of the flexural gravity wave to broken the ice, move close for the critical speed. Later I will show you results of our calculation to improve this. So, and here you can see comparison with deflection and strain for the wave in infinity extent, in the case of infinite extent ice, and the ice in channel, so, and here very visible the difference between the infinite wave and the wave in channel. And so just mathematical background is we will use the linear equation for elastic plate, and in this case if we rewrite it through the deflection W, we will obtain that as a fourth order equation, which we will use mainly in our investigation. And so we consider the propagating sloshing wave in the frozen channel. That is, we have a coupled problem of hydroelasticity. We have elastic part of the problem and hydrodynamic part of the problem. And coupling between them goes through the pressure, hydrodynamic pressure applied for the elastic part of the problem, and hydrodynamic part depends on the deflection of the plate. And to do this, we consider the only periodic solution. We find the wave, and then for the shape function f, we obtain the following equation. And this equation can be solved by normal Mohs method. And in present case, it is a spectral problem provided here, and that is it is quite easy to solve it by analytical formula, and you can find that we have even an odd part of our problem, and very easy to present here. And of course, this spectral problem depends on the boundary conditions. Here we consider it clamped condition, which means the ice is frozen for the channel. And orthogonality condition also provided here. So substitute this expansion in our equation and integrate over the plate, multiply by the normal function. We obtain the equation in this form for the coefficients A. And we have a two matrix, which is a matrix M, is mainly depend of the velocity potential, term of the velocity potential, and can be considered like an added mass matrix. And so we should solve this problem for this function phi separately. And to solve it, we consider it hydrodynamic part of the problem, but we substitute new functions into the boundary conditions. And when we have got solution, we can find the equation. And finally, we have a matrix equation that is a homogeneous matrix. And from this homogeneous matrix, we can find everything. We can find the dispersion relation, shape function, and group of phase speed. And it was done by first paper with Alexander Koropkin and Papin, and for the clamped conditions and for the free-free conditions by me and Evgeny Batyaev. And here you can see that what is news for the channel compared with the ice of infinite extent. Ice of infinite extent have only one dispersion relation, and it is presented by the green curve. But for the channel, we have a set of dispersion equation, because we have a sloshing wave propagating, not only propagating, but sloshing wave. And also form profile of close for the form of the normal mode, but not the same, you should know. And here you can see that this group and phase speed is that is also again, we have a green curve for the wave of infinite extent ice and set for the other cases. And that is means for the, because we have a set of the minimum of phase speed, we have a set of the critical speed, set of minimum, set of critical speed. And of course, all results depend on the physical and geometrical parameter. For example, here we can see that the same curve for the clamped and for the free-free edge. And also, just we've been very unlucky when we take parameters of calculations for the length of half of the width of the channel L equal to 10 meters and depth of 2 meters and the thickness of the ice 10 centimeters, because we have a quite long about horizontal period and quite difficult to find the first critical speed here, second critical speed here. But many calculations provide with these results. So, but if we change the parameter of the channel, the minimum of the for the speed is very visible. And so here that is the results compare how to which of the channel influence for the critical speed, and of course the limit is for the infinite extent. And you can see also that I cannot show by pointer. We have a characteristical length of the lecture gravity wave. It is about 2.5 meters for given data. But influence of the wall for the critical speed only on the four length of the from the critical speed. It's very. Я не могу вот это снижать. Я нажимаю. I do it. Саша. А, окей.
Творк.
So other problem we considered that the how the pressure moving along of the center of the channel. We consider this problem, and in this problem we are solving the for the Kelvin void plate model for the plate model with the damping, and the tau is the coefficient of the damping, and we use a very smooth shape of the body, no, not body, but the shape of the applied pressure. That is was because we solved our problem through the Fourier transform, and so for the very small, that is a give proper results. And again, we use a normal mode method, and after the Fourier transform, we have the same problem for the eigenfunction like before, absolutely the same, and we obtain the similar system, but in this case the system is in some sense simpler because it is a not homogeneous solution, but it is a just direct non-homogeneous solution. And we can investigate how that is a plate deflected and stresses in the plate according to this motion. And the first case, that is a blue curve, that is the subcritical speed, when the body moves with subcritical speed. And you can see that the deflection only around of the pressure region. And if the second case, that is a red curve, that is a supercritical speed, we can see that the wave moves forward before the body, and for just one set of the wave, actually. And on the green speed, green line for the very subcritical speed with the three cross section, we have a set in front of the body and from the body. That is a, here you can see that is a deflection along of the central line and across of section. And we can see that is a, with subcritical speed, we have only one minimum, which is a mean that is mainly influenced for the first mode, and red curve that is a main influence for the second even mode, and green curve with the influence of the higher order model. And this is the same for the strain along of the central line and along of the wall. And if we wish to estimate maximum value of the load, which is leads to the broken, for the subcritical speed, we should the move body is about the 400 kilogram at the central line, and the crack will be along of the central line. But for the supercritical speed, that is again the same mass, but the crack will arise near the wall. But what will be happened if we start to move with the critical speed? You can see the blue line is the same. And here also that is a, for stresses is again that is a blue and red line that is a, quite small and move here, but other stresses and deflection is much higher for the critical speed. And even for the critical speed, the mass it's about 20 kilograms. That is means that 20 times less than for critical, for subcritical or supercritical speed. And if you wish to broken the ice, we should use a very small mass. So that the critical speed is very important in the sense of the how we should move along of the convoy on ice road. Again, but of course, real number depend of the retardation time, about the viscosity of the ice, ice properties, thickness of the ice. But that is because we have a changing difference by order, not twice, not three times, but by several orders. That is very important. And that's again, I show the same slide. That is how to hovercraft broken ice. It should move close for the critical speed. And here, that is the other case, that other experiment, how to broken ice, but underwater body. And again, it was found that the critical speed, like second minimum, and the reaction of the ice, even that the calculation performed with the different conditions, that is a very close behavior, non-regular, non everything. And here you can see effect of the damping coefficients. That is, of course, if the damping coefficients is very small, we have about periodic wave in front of the body. But if we increase the damping, we reduce the wave in front of the body. And also, according to, when we work under this way, this paper, we realize that the length of the wave is in very good agreement for the further speed. And we just have we have an improvement at that time, but we can see it. We can observe it, but to more deeply investigate for the large time response of the ice, we consider it as a problem without the damping, that is in some sense an artificial problem, but that is a theoretical problem, but this problem gives us the proper understanding what has happened. For the large time, we can present our plate deflection in the form of the series. In the form of the series, and where that is we have a wave which is a propagate for under the body, waves that propagate above the body and the forward one, and it is depend of the velocity of the body. For example, here for the value 25, we have a three cross of the further speed, and one of them have a negative derivative, and so that is a wave propagate above the body, and the two set with a short wave which is propagate in front of the body. And we also have the term which is a not wave term, but just some symmetrical term, and other that is a two wave term, and that is a we can obtain the amplitude of the propagating wave, and also the cutoff function, which is give zero on one infinity and unit for another infinity, depend of the which way the wave propagate. And so calculation we performed, and you can see the two set of the wave with the given amplitude, with the finite amplitude, and that is the term which is a non-wave, that is just a local deflection and cutoff function that is smooth but not very smooth but not just step function, and that is the final calculations for this case. That is which provides that is a deflection along of the channel, and if you introduce that is a retardation time, the damping coefficient, then we of course that the wave propagated in front of the body is reduced. So other problem which was considered the problem of the underwater body, and we modeled by dipole it, and the again results is a very good agreement with the previous results and understanding how which wave propagate before the body, in front of the body, and follow of the body. And in some sense that is a very new part which was the start of the last year, that is a plate of the linear syncness. That is in this case the plate equation stay more complicated, you can see. And and elastic part of the problem, even for the periodic wave, that is a stay more complicated. But if we separate this part, we can find that is a solve the spectrum problem, and actually the result we start to think about this problem because one of Sasha's postgraduate students find the paper with the function that is a solution of this problem by the Bessel functions. That's an analytical solution by the Bessel function for the linear beam. And but maybe it is not she find other, but I go through the literature and find this paper. Maybe that is first, maybe not first, I don't know. But anyway, we have a we can solve this problem, we find the new normal mode in some sense, and afterward we can normalize this mode, taking into account the thickness of the beam or the plate, and then we can solve our problem by the similar wave like we do it before. And later we considered two cases. One case is just a linear beam from the minus B to B. Another is like a symmetrical case, and that is again they provide a similar wave, but the matrix of course is a bit different, but many of them obtained analytically. It is very important, and again we can find that is everything shape functions, dispersion relation, group and phase speed. And here that is some sample how to shape of the wave across the channel change with the thickness of the plate. If we have a red curve on that is a four form, and a red curve and cross on them at the for like for homogeneous plate. Across for homogeneous alpha equal to 0.05 is for small inclination, and the biggest one that is the magenta curve is the inclination which is about that this means the plate is like a triangular cross section, and so you can see the deflection change for move for the thinner edge in this case of course. And again, the dispersion relation change, but compare with the homogeneous plate, and change compare with the different configuration of the plate cross section. And also here that is the results for different inclination angle, and you can see that as a dispersion relation frequency stay low for the bigger inclination of the we keep that the average thickness is the same, but the change in inclination, and that is curve for the phase speed, and again phase speed go a bit down for this case. That is, we can calculate stresses along strain along the plate, and the in the crack along the Along the channel may arise, for the case, closer for the senior age, but other than that strain across the channel, and this strain move for closer for the sick age, if the we consider it high number of the modes. And that is a different strain for combination for the other case, for symmetrical case. And again, everything very well depend of the shape, inclination, and other parameters. And finally, this paper was, this results was published by the paper in the journal Water. But what we can do if the plate have an arbitrary thickness? Because that is a usually question for us both. You use the normal MOS method, and according to the normal MOS method, you can truncate only with a very simple configuration. But now, if you have a arbitrary plate, we can divide it onto the paths, and in each path we have doing piecewise linear approximation, not homogeneous, but linear, which is much more smoothly. And if we combine this modus solve according to the modus, and modus combine in each path, then we can obtain results. It was done and presented this year in Rome by Konstantin Shishmaryov in the paper. And what we should consider it. If we have a piece with the homogeneous thickness, we use the normal mode, which as I told in the initial part of my talk. If we have a linear thickness, we use the normal mode and approach with the second part of talk. And of course, if the derivative of the thickness is equal to zero, that is means the homogeneous, that is the same problem. And we use the cosine and sine for the homogeneous plane and Bessel function for linear path, and we can combine it, and the conditions for the point that is the deflection is the same, that is the inclination is the same, shear force is the same, and the momentum depends on the thickness. So, and the orthogonality condition. So we again apply the same scheme, and we can obtain the results for the different configuration. Maybe it is not, peculiarities is not so interesting, but of course, again, depend on the shape of the body, at a critical speed depend of the shape of the body, and possible analyze. But in my opinion, the main results is that we can do this for the arbitrary shape. And this plot just demonstrates that is how to provide it. And maybe I should say that as according to the strain, that the strain is the change very fast for the for the low wave, according to the plate where the thickness change rapidly in the point. No reaction in the point which is close for this one. And also one of the next problems that is a compressive ice in the channel. If we introduce a compression of the ice, we introduce new term in the our equation, which I presented at the beginning. And that is in the plate equation, we again have the additional term here, where coefficients k is give the compression stiffness of the plate. And then we can solve our problem again by similar wave, similar procedure. And we can compare dispersion relation for phase speed and for is the case without compression and with the case with compression. That is some coefficients that is equal to one. And you can see that all curve compared with previous go down a bit. according to the compression. And in some sense limited case, we can see that the 2Q of the first and second order stay very close. And we spend some time to find that in this case, that is a possible configuration when the green curve, which is correspond the even more even and tot mistake that the two wave can propagate at the same speed, or even the second order can propagate with the without the first motors. So, and also I should that the told about the results which provide with the, our Chinese colleague, and that is about the ship numerical calculation about the ship move through the ice channel with the lids. And initially they present that as a, they considered propagation of the wave of the body, they believe that critical speed for ice sheet of infinite extent, they calculate as 11.1, that is a middle plot. And in the middle plot, when I see on this, I cannot say that is a critical speed, because it's a very regular behavior wave into the channel, and that is a bit opposite of the body in the ice, but no, nothing about the critical speed. And when we start investigate what has happened, where is the maximum deflection and where is the maximum stresses in the ice age, and it was found that is not exactly at the point 11.1 how they believe, but in some other region. And for example, if we consider the speed if the 13 meter per second, then we can see that the deflection in front of the body, opposite of the body, and through or ice plate. So the critical speed may be found in some region between the two maxima, and that is of course that is a much more look like a body with move with the critical speed. And second paper that is also people from Harbin investigate that is a wave propagating along of the ice channel with the lids and it with the some polynya. And of course, at the beginning, the dispersion relation for the long waves is very close for the open water, infinite ice, and for the case with the lids and with the crack. But for the long time dispersion relation, the, of course, that the thickness, the channel, the open water is much more important and give a big influence on all of the curve. And again, for the phasor speed, we have several maximum and minimum for each curve. And then maybe according to our theory, if a body will move with this speed, we can have the several set of the wave which is propagated in front of the body or opposite of the body and the back of the body. So double critical speed possible, and so many things happened. And that is conclusion of my talk. The hydroelastic wave is very important and have a very different properties. We introduce new method and we can, for design, we can should use that as a analytical method. We have analytical method to predict some peculiarities. And because I have time, I also wish to no, just story about the rod of life, which was a close for the Lake Ladoga, St. Petersburg, Leningrad, here, and that is was only one rod from the the Soviet Union, according to the Ladoga, that is was open that is two winter, that is winter of the 1941, 42, and 42 and 43. And that is and you can see the several picture of this road. And what does people say that as when people, that is again that is because was war that is this road was bombed, but because the ice is very fragrant, that is bomb fall down through, not very disturb the road. But when car move for the city, they was very heavy. And they move very slowly, according and nothing happened. But when we going back, the main car was quite light, and driver decided to turn faster, move faster. And there was several cases when they just in this because they go faster, they go, come like for the critical speed, and they just go down under the ice. It is a real story. That's all.
Yeah, that works. Thank you, Tanya. Mm-hmm. Any questions from the audience and online? So maybe in which case the ice road can be compressed? You studied the under compression. So is it over lakes when you have large scale compression?
I guess in the channel it is possible. We consider compression on the between the wall. And so maybe in the condition of the frozen, maybe of the other condition that is changing, maybe.
Okay, when the channel is fully ice covered.
Yes. Okay. Oh, I see that some paper by the Mike Mailand, by Sturova, with the compressor ice in the open water, and usually was questioned, but in our case, in something more understandable. Mm-hmm.
Quick question. The hypothesis is that the water under the ice is at rest. Has anyone looked at if the water is moving, if you have a current, would it change the dispersion relation?
I don't know. That is...
Just a curiosity.
Maybe change because it is because if water is moving, that is the pressure distribution should be changed.
Answer the question. I think I'm not absolutely sure that Roger Hoskin considered a current under an ice sheet with a moving load.
Yes, yes, he considered, but I remember 5 years ago we speak with Roger Hoskin here, and that is he says that is a new of that is we have a channel, we have an additional dispersional curve, additional conditions. Because in any mathematical problem, if you change that is a boundary condition, the full problem and full solution can be changed.
I'm sorry for asking a question, but one slide was new for me. It seems that compression, in one slide you said that for the channel with ice in compression, there are no critical speeds.
No, we have critical speed.
Is it? Could you show the back?
Oh, back.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, back. The with compression, with compression, and then it was the graph. Yeah, it's graph with the phase speed, and it seems there are no minimum speed. That means no critical speed.
That is a high region of the critical speed. That is quite difficult to understand. That is again because that is a calculation we perform with the same like before, and that case also was a quite horizontal piece of the phase speed. But here we can see that is a.
So critical speed is for k greater than 0.3. No. Because here I cannot see. Bottom right figure, there are no minimum of phase speed.
But yes.
No, all others, they also should have a critical speed, but the that one, yellow one.
Сейчас I will show you. Well, advanced.
So they, I understand there are no critical speed for open water. But for ice, there is critical speed. But if ice is compressed, again, no critical speed. So that would be interesting.
I explained that in the our first paper, we take that not proper conditions.
You can see
that is the period from the 0 point till the 0.4. That is the first critical
Right, but this is it for first mode. For the second and for third, it's fine, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So but I'm talking about third mode.
The third mode it has a critical.
No,
speed.
No. For with compression.
With compression, third mode have.
Could you?
But,
could you show? Now it's. Yeah. With compression. We have time. Yeah, that one. So top left, top right.
That is the minimum here.
No, right. The blue, yellow line. Yellow line
and this also have a critical speed, but that
okay.
is
okay. For K greater than 0.3. Fine.
Standing the graphs.
No, of course, that is a piece just to demonstrate that is a here, that is a two about the horizontal pieces, and that is a I go all together, so that is a second and first mode propagate with the same speed, and that is a have about the same critical speed.
Hi, I was wondering how the ice thickness influences the critical speed for a moving ship in a channel. Was my question clear?
Sorry, I don't understand. That
so
is a...
you have a critical speed for a ship passing through the channel?
Yeah.
And I was wondering if the ice thickness influences the value for the critical speed.
Of course.
And what is the relationship? Is there an analytical relationship, or it's numerical?
I guess that is not so simple a relationship. That is that is should be investigated and calculated separately for the every case. Maybe I told that the all critical speed, all parameters depend of many things. That is the depth, thickness of the channel, thickness of the open water and so the thickness of the ice, and that's many.
Okay, great.
No, not straightforward, not simple.
Okay.
Thank you. Any other questions? We still have a bit of time, although it's going to be lunchtime. We can thank you again, Tanya. Or okay, you have a message. Yeah.
No
okay.
questions.
Thank you. Thank you. All the speakers.
Thank you very much, Dani, for chairing this session. So now it's lunch. After lunch, we have two presentations by Yuri Semyonov and another one. And just two, 30 minutes each. Then tea, afternoon tea, not coffee break. Even we drink coffee, it's called afternoon tea. And after that, it's scheduled for 30 minutes, but it could be as long as we want. It will be discussion session. And please come to that discussion session. Discussion session is important because it could give you, your students, new topics for research and new directions, in some sense approved by experts in that field. Okay, so please come. Thank you. The Agnieszka Herman will chair the session after lunch.
Now I...
Long time.